Hey, it's KMA. How's your day today? And welcome to the corner. Today we're playing F1 2015, and we're at the third race. The first race I qualified in second place, which was really good. Then I was in first place or close to first place, and I crashed out, and I didn't end up winning that. But the second race I qualified in first, and I raced in first, and I won. So I think it's time to change the difficulty. Let's see. British settings. Customize controls. No advanced. No force feedback. No audio graphics options. No, I don't want that. I want to figure out how to modify your game settings or difficulty. Yeah, that's what I want. It's looking at me right in the face, I know it. I'll go through every single one of these. Driving controls is that. Oh, actually, you know what? I gotta set it to the custom one because that's the one I use. Let me see. That was actually kind of good that I came here. Nope. Back, back, back. Escape. Nope, it's not in there. Let's see. Force feedback. I'm back. Alright. Then there's nothing in that one. Audio settings. Of course, there's nothing in there. Okay, I don't care. Graphics. What's a track mode? Oh, let me. Hands roll big. With pick assistance, enable the car will automatically exit the pit lane. And only hand control of the car back to the player. Okay, I don't know what I just did there. Well, we'll find out. We'll find out. Sure enough. That's what happens when you put away a game for a couple of weeks. Forget how to play it. Forget how to use the menu system. Forget where all the settings are. And I know it's something really simple, and I've looked right at it, but whatever. So what are we doing? We're hurting my ears. That's what we're doing. This looks like just a replay. Settings. Let's see if these settings are usually... What is that noise? Okay, vehicle tuning. No, I want difficulties. Oh, come on. Not this one. Okay, let's just go into the season. And continue. And I think I might be able to do it in here, maybe. But we're in China. Is this race settings? All driver level, medium, hard, expert, okay, legend. So we were doing easy, so all right. We'll just go up to medium. Jeez, it took me 4 minutes to figure out how to do that. What a loser. All right, we are going to do the practice. Figure out these tracks, because most of these tracks I don't know how to use. I've never race them, or if I have, it was a long time ago with like Gran Turismo. All right, let's start session. It's funny, I hear Stacy in the background trying to be quiet doing dishes.
This weekend sees us arrive in Shanghai for the Chinese Grand Prix. First up is today's practice.
That was a dish.
This is a popular location for many of the teams. The circuit is extremely demanding for both the drivers and the cars, and that makes it a very exciting place to race.
Have we already raced here?
Riding a good set of challenges when racing. It has two long straights that allow for great overtaking opportunities.
Well, I did do a couple of quick races, so maybe this is one of the tracks I did a quick race at. But I'm pretty familiar with this track.
Max Verstappen was a record breaker at the Australian Grand
Prix. Max Verstappen.
Youngest ever F1 driver to take to the grid. He beat Jaime Alguersuari's previous record of 19 years and 125 days.
Mm-hmm.
It shows the great potential that they believe Max has to promote him so early. I'm sure he'll be eager to repay their faith out on the track.
I love those stupid things. Alright, let's go to the track. Forget about the setup. I don't know enough to change it. Alright, F1, let's get out there. Hopefully we do have everything set up properly. Probably not, but it's half the fun. Okay, a little bit of the fun. It's not half the fun. Alright. The game sounds... I turned my mic down a little bit, so now the game sounds are a lot more. Alright. So... that is one hell of a long turn. I thought the first race was at this place. I don't know. This track looks... I know this track. I don't know. I'm not a big fan of this track. I'm not a big fan of any track because they're difficult. Come on. Gotta do better than that, Mr. Huckleberg. Get out of my way. Aw, come on. I was just having a little fun. Sweeping turn. Is this a straightaway? The backstretch? What? Where? Oh no, not the checkered flag. This is just a straightaway. I gotta remember to brake a little bit earlier than I think on that turn. That one's not too bad. We'll rate the turns of annoyance, because that's what they are. They're annoying. This one I like, though. I like long sweeping turns, because they tend to be a little bit tougher on me. They're more challenging. I kind of like that. And to have the left turn off of it is kind of cute. Especially a long one, too. That was an interesting design. Probably my favorite part of the course, that design back there. I never like hairpin turns, so they can keep them out for all I care. Gosh. If you do that last turn properly, it's right, then that usually is followed up by a good turn there, but this turn, a little big. But I like the way it comes out. There we go. Another kind of hairpin turny that I don't like. Alright. Massive turn. Position 3. Is that because of my beating somebody up earlier? Let's see if I can get this one right. We'll do it at the 100. I should have held onto the brakes a little bit longer. I think I started braking at the right time, but I didn't hold on to them long enough. That one I messed up. Fastest lap.
You've just put in the quickest lap of the session so far.
Oh, that's what I was trying to figure out. Was I the guy? Or was that just my fastest lap? But I guess I was the fastest lap. So maybe we're going to be moving up from medium soon. Jeez. As I say that, I can't drive. Just to think, I could be your Uber driver. And sometimes I do think my 95 horsepower Nissan Versa is a Formula One racer. But at least I keep that one on the road. Like they always say, how long it takes to get to a specific destination on the app when you're doing Uber, let's say like 22 minutes, and I'm like, I'm usually like one third faster than it says. So if it's like 6 minutes, I'm usually there in four. If it says 21 minutes, I'm usually there in 14. Just learn to drive in Boston, you learn to drive aggressive, you learn to drive properly. 100. Yes. You know, right before the 100. That was pretty close. Right. I had that hairpin almost. Kilos, so that's like 12 pounds. So kilos, 2.2 pounds each. I don't know, it almost seems like better if I put on the brakes early. Crap. Then slide through the turn. I don't know. Like while I'm still in the braking area, put on the brakes early, then let go of the brakes a little bit right before the turn, then turn and hit the brakes again. That's how that hairpin works back there. Yeah, that seemed to be pretty good too. Whatever. Pit this. I don't like my guy on the other end of my mic, I guess. Yeah, that wasn't too bad. It was better than the last one. I gotta get this. No, that turn I have pretty good. Get off my wheels. What I'm kind of learning is yellow on the track doesn't mean necessarily hit the brakes. It just kind of means let off the gas. Did that turn right? Uh-oh. Got a little excited there. Not a turn cut. Okay. I thought I might have been flagged there for cutting the corner. How's that for a turn cut? Invalid lap time. Aw, man, really? Okay, I'm gonna do one more lap. I cut that corner too. Okay, I gotta start doing this like a person should. Concentrate again. Hopefully I don't run out of gas this lap. Oh, come on. It's kind of amazing. Each lap, the car feels different because it's lighter. You know, it takes things like that into consideration, it feels like, because I'm turning, I think, a lot better. I just need to memorize these tracks and I'll be much better. That's the one I cut earlier? No, it isn't. I think I do better when I have a car in front of me. It makes me focus a little bit better. Because it's like, ooh, a car. I got some competition. That's right, let me through. Mm-hmm. I'll take that. I was gonna put you into the wall, but I decided against it. Does that mean I can make it around the track again? Because I just passed the pits, because I didn't know where they were. Kilo at 2.2. I don't know how much a gallon weighs, but we'll see. I hope I don't need to be towed off the track. That would kind of be embarrassing. I don't know if they even do that in the game, but that would be funny. Alright, this guy annoyed me. I'm gonna get you. Whatever. I'm having fun with Verstappen. I don't know if he's doing a little bit more aggressiveness, but I like it. And I have pretty good control of the cars now. It seems better. Not perfect, but I don't mind waving it around a little bit. I think I have run out of gas. Alright. I'll just stay over here. The pit's right there. Close to finishing the lap. Now it shows me in position 3. I didn't lose, yeah, I left the track. Don't worry about it. I am in third because 143 was my fastest. Okay, so these guys are a little bit better. Ah, yep, that's a tire. You want to keep looking at my tire? Oh. What are you, cooling it down or something? Oh my. That sound. Mm-hmm. And that's going to be it for this episode of F1 2015. I'm in China. I qualified. Next one, I will be racing. See you then. Goodbye.